Hey everybody, hope you guys are all healthy and safe. So this is the Cosmo Communicator. And yeah, as you can tell, this is basically a mini size laptop with the major difference being you can put a SIM card into this and use it as a phone. You can make phone calls with this. So this is kind of like a smartphone slash laptop. Yes, it is slightly bulky, but not too bad. So this is the Samsung Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. They're actually about the same size in terms of height and width. Obviously, the Cosmo Communicator is a little bit thicker, but not too bad. I feel like nowadays in 2020, we're all using phones that are this large, so this phone does not feel out of place anymore. It fits into my pocket just fine, although it is slightly heavy at 326 grams. So for those of you who may not have heard of Planet Computers, they are a British computer gadget company, and about a decade ago, they used to make these PDAs, you know, basically a smartphone before the era of smartphones, called the Zion PDA, and this is basically a throwback to that design. So let's take a look at the hardware first. So you have a 2-inch OLED screen here. As you can see, it shows you time, date, and your notifications. So you can tap on it, you can actually read some of your notifications if you need. And then you have a button right here that when you press, you can go into a shortcut menu. From here, you can activate the camera. You also have here an icon for a flashlight, and this will actually come in handy. It is a voice recorder. So if you're in a meeting, if you want to record something, you can set it to record without even opening up the clamshell. Now this button right here is also the fingerprint scanner. So you can just scan your digit and it'll unlock the phone from outside, or when it's opened up, you can scan it by just placing your finger on the back. Now up here and down low, you have a little sliver right here. Now both of these houses an earpiece and a mic. So that means when you're talking on the phone, you can hold it this direction or this direction. No matter which way you hold the phone, the other party will be able to hear you. And I've tested that already. So just from the outside, you already have a very functional phone with limited smart capabilities. Then you open it up and this is the main event. So you have a 6-inch LCD panel, resolution of 2160 by 1080. It is not the best looking panel I've seen. I mean, it's not even the second or third best panel I've seen, but it gets the job done because this is not a machine that you plan on watching a lot of movies with. This is a work machine, as you can see with this QWERTY keyboard right here. Now, this keyboard is really nice. It has very nice tactile feedback and travel. When you type onto it, keys actually bounce back at you. It's a very enjoyable keyboard, perhaps the best keyboard I've typed on in a pocketable device. Now, in terms of size, this measures about 7 inches diagonally, so it's not a full-size keyboard per se, but I find that if you are a skilled touch typer like I am, you can actually get used to typing without looking at the keyboards very quickly. It only took me about 10 minutes. As soon as my index finger finds the spot that they need to be at, I can begin typing full sentences. You know, you need to adjust a little bit because the keys are slightly more cramped, but for the most part, I can type on this much faster than I can type on a touchscreen keyboard, and that is the whole point of this device. This is a work machine, and to that end, Planet Computer has built a UI that prioritizes office work. So you have this menu right here, this bar right here, that has a couple of Planet apps. One of them, it's a note-taking app, and then the other one, it's a calendar app. And then there's also a dock that you can bring up by tapping on this Planet button right here. And you'll see there are more productivity office-based apps right here, such as Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, and a couple of other apps that I'm probably not even going to use because I don't work out of an office that much. Now, the core software running on this is Android 9. So yes, it is unfortunately quite a bit outdated. But hey, everything still works. You can still run Instagram, Twitter on this, anything fine. But as you can see here, this screen aspect ratio, it's not ideal for a lot of Android apps because this is a wide aspect ratio, whereas Android apps traditionally like to run vertical. Now, supposedly, Planet Computer gives you the option to rotate the orientation. You can even see the option right here, right? But for some reason, I cannot get it to work out of the box. No matter how many times I rotate the phone, it will not rotate orientation. The good news is, this is Android, so there's a third-party app that can fix that. So I downloaded this app called Rotation, and with this app enabled, now I can force the phone to go into portrait orientation. Now this makes watching like Instagram stories a lot better. I mean, technically, if you're watching Instagram stories like this, you cannot really watch anything because it's cut off so much. But now with that app that forces rotation, now you can watch Instagram stories fine. And it's not like the screen is that great for watching widescreen videos too, because of these giant ass bezels that take up the left and right side. So it's not like you're getting a super immersive experience. Speaking of watching videos, let's test the speakers right now. So you have shortcut buttons right here that you can increase the volume and screen brightness just by holding onto the function key and tapping the keyboard. So yeah, you have stereo speakers on the left and right side. So for a pocketable, portable machine, these speakers are actually pretty good. Now, I already mentioned that I can type on this keyboard like a typical laptop without much issues. I can type on this pretty fast. But this keyboard is also small enough that I can hold it up like this, like a handheld machine, and I can just type this way with my thumbs. You do need to reach a little bit to the middle rows, but for the most part, I can do this, and I've been using this out and about like this. I can still type like this faster than I can type on a smartphone touchscreen keyboard. Now, as I mentioned, there's a 24 megapixel camera right here, and it is just not that good. Shutter speed is really slow, and for the most part, colors look really dull. Now, there's also a selfie camera around the front. It's a 5 megapixel selfie camera, but this also sucks. This is like the blurriest selfie camera I've seen. It always looks like there's a lot of fog in front of me or something. It's just not a good selfie camera at all. I mean, look at how blurry it is. I wonder if something's like wrong with it. It's always just things are not clear. But I don't think that would be that big of an issue, because after all, who's gonna buy this machine to take selfies? This is once again a work device. And to that end, there's a 6 gigs of RAM in here with 128 gigs of internal storage. Now, both of these are a little bit low, but I find that the software UI has been running pretty smoothly without any lags or stutters. So 6 gigs of RAM so far is okay. As for storage, the good news is you can expand the storage via micro SD card. There is indeed a micro SD card slot with the SIM tray. Now, you may notice that there's also a headphone jack right here. So that's good news to a lot of you. And there's also 2 USB-C ports. Both of these ports can charge the device and also output to an external display. So that's another good use of this machine. In terms of battery life, there's a 4,200 milliamp hour battery inside. If you're using this as a smartphone, meaning you have it in your pocket most of the day and you only take it out to send WhatsApp messages and emails, it's enough to last you all day. But if you actually have it open with multiple documents open and you're using this as a work computer, like a laptop, then this will drain in about 4 to 5 hours. Ultimately, I'm a big fan of this keyboard, but I also know that I might be in the minority because, you know, I'm in my mid-30s, so I grew up in an era before smartphones, and back in that era, everybody wanted a machine that had a physical keyboard that allowed you to send emails and go on AIM Instant Messenger. So back in the early 2000s, I had the T-Mobile Sidekick, and that was one of my favorite devices. I loved to just walk around just to be able to text my friends like that, and this really brings back that same memory. I really like this full-size keyboard that allows me to type at really fast speeds. And the keys are very bouncy with a lot of travel. It's just a very satisfying feeling having something so tactile. But at the same time, this is a very niche appeal. Let's say you're 23, you might be someone whose only typing experience comes from tapping keyboard. You might not even use a proper computer keyboard that much anymore. And to those people, this machine will seem really outdated. And I agree, because the age of foldable phones is coming. The Samsung Galaxy Fold 2, it's gonna come in like 2 or 3 weeks. And that phone, it's gonna allow us to have a similar typing experience, except instead of a physical keyboard, you'll be typing on a touchscreen. But because the screen real estate is so large, you should be able to type on that touchscreen with relatively high speeds too. So for anyone under like 30, that's gonna be the way to go. They don't want something this clunky with a physical keyboard. This is for old people like me. So this device does have appeal, but it has a very niche appeal. It doesn't help that it's relatively expensive too. Planet Computers is selling this for around $600 US. And I forgot to talk about the chipset. It's a Helio P70 inside, so it's not the most powerful Android chipset. And I already showed you the screen is just average at best. So really, 600 bucks for this is probably a little bit on the pricier side, but there will be people who might be interested in picking up one, like older people like me, really. So that's it for now. I'm gonna have more content coming up in the next few days. So please subscribe to my channel if you like this video, or follow me on Instagram at Ben's Gadget Reviews. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching.